Hey everybody, you're listening to Dead Air. Again, it's been a while. Come back to doing a playthrough. Had 2.9 coming out. Had a few issues going on as well. Anyway, I just finally got to a point I wanted to wait on 2.9 to come out. Then I realized that people weren't showing recordings because 2.9 was brand new and you didn't want to do things that exposed storyline stuff right off the bat. But now some other people have put some stuff out. I'm not the one with the spoilers and everything. And it seems okay to do it now. We still have a few issues they're wanting to fix, but let's see, we're going to go to single player and Galactic Conquest. I'm not going right back to the Black Sun. One of the main reasons is, one, the mirror cruisers are bugged, and they're doing way too much damage, apparently. I guess it's just a close-range turbo lasers. Single close-range turbo lasers, not double or quads or anything. According, I believe it was Maxim that mentioned that while I was watching Captain Shaq play. But he also said that they had plans for the Black Sun. And I don't know how far off this is, but he was saying something about reducing their number of planets. So, that sounds like that could be a really interesting challenge once they fixing the mirror cruisers, which gives more of a challenge if you're playing against them. Oh, I've noticed other players very much struggling against the Black Sun as well, and that's part of it. But other people, by the way, this is full campaign. I'm seeing people play this. If you're playing without the Black Sun, you're really losing so much of the flavor of this game. But especially if you're playing and you're doing recordings for other people to see. At least to me. I mean, this is just my opinion, but this makes it a lot duller by taking out the Black Sun, which is such a huge part of the flavor of Awakening of the Rebellion. I tried playing around some with some of these random things where you get random worlds, but that's basically turning it into a bit of a 4X game, it seems like. And for me, it got dull pretty quick. I didn't want to keep it up, and I didn't want to do, you know, I kind of did recordings, but I held back on them, and I just got rid of them because they weren't anything I wanted to put up. So we're going to go with the full campaign. We're seeing lots of people play the Rebellion. I kind of wanted to play the Rebellion. I think the Rebellion, other than bugged out ships creating some extra power for some people, for at least the Black Sun faction, I think the Rebels sit in a really good spot, and there's stuff I would like to do with them, but it just seems like that's what most of the people are doing. So I'm going to play as the Empire. And I think this is the hardest one right now. I really kind of do. And I'm going to, just because some people are, Captain Shaq's turning on expert. I'm not saying I'm as good as him. I might lose real bad here, but I don't want to turn it down from there. It just makes it feel kind of weak sauce. And let me go ahead and hit the start button because it's going to take it a minute. I do not have like the newest, latest, greatest systems. Our system, which you might be able to tell even from the sound quality. I even have a cheap headphones that I need something that sounds better than this, I know. And by the way, for everybody that does, I apologize for that. Because I know I've tried watching videos before and people have bad sound quality, and it makes it kind of grindy to end up watching it. But right now it is what it is. I actually tried finding something. I want something that'll be comfortable for me, but also have better sound. And I'm not really setting, I don't care to set myself up with an expensive microphone set like, I don't know. Like the actual desk-mounted microphone and all that, like I'm on the radio or whatever. Is this thing gonna go?
Mission
there
log
we go.
Updated.
Really, I don't know why I don't go ahead and let it go, because I don't care about the copyright stuff right here. If they hit me on the copyright, so be it. There's my mouse. Okay. Get this done. There you go. Awakening of the Rebellion, Space Tech. Okay. Let's turn on all the things. Now notice this is 2.9 if you're not used to it. By the way, if anybody plays Empire at War and you just think you're not a mod person, I'm just imagining some people thinking that way. You're really missing out, because especially this mod here, it is such a more fulfilling game this way. It's not hard. It's not that hard. I realize it's not the same as just, you know, downloading Angry Birds on your phone. But you actually do have to, you have to click on Steam. You just have to subscribe to a mod in Steam. It's very easy to do. But you can get in here and get to playing this game without any difficulties. Without any bad difficulties. Let's see. We have a lot of vulnerabilities, but here we have a lot of stuff that's costing us a lot of money. I'm gonna sell these. Notice instead of it being instead of hypervelocity cannons, it's now ground planetary turbo laser. I don't know exactly. I mean, it's works similarly, as far as I understand, from what I've seen and experienced. But I am really, I need money. I'm getting rid of a whole bunch of this stuff, and I'm gonna point this out for people. I got two planets I can really do this on. More or less, I have space mines. Now, unless I'm just doing my math really wrong here, if you'll notice the space mine, you can build it. It actually has some weapons and so on. It has a small garrison. It's not much, but there's actually a little bit of added space defense. It has a weekly income of 500 credits. There's nothing associated with the planet. You know, no one times the planet income, nothing like that. It also does have a bonus to freighter if you're doing that. But it only costs 2,500. Whereas, if I get down here, the Tabana gas refiners that we all know and love, the weekly income is 500. It's the same income. It also has the same freighter delivery thing, but it costs 5,000. It costs twice as much. So, and let's see, then the Tabana gas refinery is, what has it got? It has some flat guns, and it has some, it has even less of a complement, I guess, it appears to. This is more for your defense and the same money. And we also have one here at Kessel.
Building under construction.
How about that?
Combat maneuvers initiated.
The way this is going, and I've seen it happen with other people, and it's just a plan that I have, I'm going to go ahead and back out of Jaeger Minor right here off the bat. It's just caught between a rock and a hard place. There's significant Rebel fleet here, significant Black Sun fleet here. I need to come back here and defend or something. So, here we go. Well, let's send her.
Right away.
Mission log updated.
Navigating.
Okay, let me, this is just my instruction. Look, okay, yeah. All the good stuff. Again, if you're not familiar with this mod or this update, you have all kinds of information on the updates to weapons, space role, the roles as in fighter. Well, the different fighters. Well, let's see. I'm messing this up now. Bomber, heavy bomber. They break this down more. Gunship, heavy gunship support, ship fleet tender, disabler, screener, there we go, screener, hunter, destroyer, monitor, okay, all this stuff. There's a lot here to read. It's a lot of really good information if you're not familiar with it. This is how shields and armor actually work now. There's different types of shields, different types of armor that handle different types of weaponry, better and worse. This is something I had not been paying attention to before, and I don't know how much, is this a change? Did I just miss this before or what? But, like, Dantooine is that, it adds 22 to my pop cap? Because Coruscant only has 20. But I noticed we have some that are very large, like Dantooine. Deltooine is 23. I mean, there's some nice amounts to pop cap there. These nice big two-digit numbers. Whereas, like, Aga Minor here is 6. Well, that's still not bad. But Ord Mantell here is 8. So some really good, powerful planets that you think about might not necessarily be adding big to the pop cap. Some planets are adding, like, 2, okay? I mean, there's 1 for the Intersection 5. Okay, well, enough of that. Let's try to get into playing this somewhat. There's tons of stuff to look at. I'm concentrating my forces here at Kessel, and I am building that... I need more military strength here, but we do need money. I've got a lot at the moment, but I've got some stuff I need to do with it. And building up some ground forces
upgrade under construction
is going to be a very big part of that.
Upgrade under construction.
I want to build up to elites here, I think, and this will be up to standard. And Bill Bringy. Is this, I mean, this is not, that's just an Imperial medium dockyard. What am I going to get in the advanced? I'm just going to be, until I tech up, I'm not going to be able to get anything for that, am I? See, this is one thing. This is, by the way, whenever I talked about the Empire being such a challenge, you really have so few answers for fighters.
Constructing unit.
I don't know what else to say there. It's.
I call, babe.
Navigating.
For the glory of the Empire.
Okay. I'm pulling everything here to Naboo because I have some pretty substantial defenses in other places.
Confirm.
Down here. I mean, Sullust and Eridu. Well, Malastare is behind the lines, but Sullust and Eridu, they're not really facing anything of that great a strength, and they have some pretty good static defenses. Eridus, I want to defend on the ground.
Constructing unit.
And,
combat maneuvers initiated.
Tactical battle imminent.
Okay, look at what all they got here. I mean, so there's a lot here at Ord Mantell. Until we tech up, I mean, we just don't have any good answers for even Black Sun fighters are not nearly as powerful as the Rebellion's fighters, the Alliance's fighter, whatever. But we don't have answers for any of them. Not good answers, anyway. I mean, all I can do is try to concentrate my forces somewhat and hopefully hold out. If I have to, perhaps I can counterattack.
Tactical battle imminent.
And I forgot to grab this, but I will in just a moment. But yes, I'm taking advantage of the retreat mechanic just to explain if no one is familiar with it. If you haven't seen some other videos, I mentioned it on multiple occasions. It seems everything I've seen from whenever you retreat, regardless of the lanes, the hyperspace lanes are meaningless. They don't have anything to do where you came from, doesn't mean anything. Where the hyperspace lanes are doesn't mean anything. You will retreat to the physically closest location where you control the orbit. And by you controlling the orbit, I mean you have either or station or ships in orbit. A single fighter group in orbit will do it. But okay, he's going to Malastare, so instead of Naboo, even though Naboo would be at least on the line. On the lane, anyway. But let's see.
Jumping to sector.
But I am wanting to get these guys out of here.
Tactical battle imminent.
And again, Jakku further from Jeddah than Freshia is, so I should be retreating to Freshia. I guess should be it. Fresia. But like even here at Jeddah, I mean these are substantial forces.
Retreat in progress.
It's not overwhelming, it's just substantial. I mean it would be difficult to beat with my combined fleet forces right here. I mean, if I combine basically everything I've got, that I could combine anyway, that would be difficult. And I might still have losses. Oh, this is one that I did notice that gets me. Little Ithor. Look at that. 28. I mean, I never really thought much about this planet. It's not the income. I mean, it's base 50. I mean, that's better than the base 25 ones. Space structures 2, space defense level 2. Black sun gets black market. That's it. I mean, there's nothing about this planet that is anything. You can't mine it. You can't do it. It's just, but bam, I never paid attention. I'm like, look at how much. What is this only planet info here? Ithor was the fourth planet located in Otega system of the Mid-Realm, one of the only members of the Galactic Republic. It was planet on the Lush Island. Known as Hammerheads. Hang on, I'm sorry, I got a cough. Okay, hopefully I blocked that out right. Anyway, I'm done taking the time to read that up completely, especially since I'm interrupting myself with coughing. But, like I said, that Ithor, if you start looking at some of these planets like that, I mean, here Merkur is... And by the way, I still always want to know the answer to this, but the wolves, if you are the Black Sun and you get this, gains 50% more health. Is that on this one planet? And if so, if it's just only applies to this one planet, which I think it does, why bother? It's like, why bother with that effect on a planet? It's like, oh, get these guys out of here.
Transmission received.
Not debate. Leaving this here for someone to see that as a ground threat. And seeing her reporting is just, well, I guess there's nobody occupying it at the moment. I could take Ithor, but I wouldn't be able to hold it for anything. Right. And, huh? Well, whatever defenses I'm trying to mess with here at Korolog, I could just move them to there, right? And Korolog is base income 75. I feel like it's just a waste. If I go there, they're going to hit me. I would need to be able to build up some static defenses first, and I just don't have the ability to defend it long enough to do that. So whoever grabs it right now, I guess.
On my way.
Oh, this is, I really want to go ahead and hurry up and get built up to the Imperial Palace here. And again, I'm only retreating. Especially since I'm just got a group of ground units here. But I don't know if anybody else has played it yet or not, but 2.9. Leave me a comment on anything that you've run into on this thing so far. There's a very limited amount I've actually played it, but man, they've the changes they made. Again, they recognize a few little bugs here with certain things that need to be repaired. Or patched, whatever you want to say. The patch is supposed to come in soon for some like the damage on the mirror cruisers, from what I understood. But the game is, they did make it tougher, which is why, like I said, putting it on expert here is a little suicidal, I'm sure. But also, like I said, from what I've seen from different people playing, the people that I've seen struggle the most, even though it did not look like they were doing anything in the world wrong to me, that I know of, but you know, who knows what a really experienced player would see. But people playing the Empire seem to really struggle, and it was, and it's definitely, it is the Black Sun eating them up. And I don't know, being someone that's played the Black Sun more, I'm hoping that I can be a little better. Not trying to be arrogant there, but hopefully I'm hoping I can be a bit better at fighting. Don't know if that's going to be the case at all or not. Okay, here he is. He's going to tell me I got to get the guy to the Maw, no doubt, from what I've seen.
Mission log updated.
Yeah, get Bevel Lemlisk to the Maw. Now, if I'm doing anything here, Ordoban, I need to strengthen it somewhat. All I have here right now, apparently, is a level 1 space station that I cannot improve. Now, here's one, and I don't know how good this is, considering generally you're going to get what you pay for, right? So, how good is this? the fact that it is mobile, the fact you can actually move it around, and if when you have a level one space station, this means I can move both of them around. But it's cheap. It's only $2,000. And it also, notice there at the bottom, additional population 5. So this helps out the pop cap, which I understand is not a problem at this time at all. I'm still almost 100 under it. But I'm wondering, what's the really good, if you're going to defend, what's really worth it? I mean, here's your population center. It gives you a population of 10. That's twice as much, and it only cost 15. But I don't know. I'm going to go with a Golan 2 here. This is just, to me, this is, because this is, you know, there's no land here. And it's all the way to, I mean, until you get to Bothawu, there's no, you know, you've basically got your highway here of all space. And well, I'm doing it that way. What's here at Maker? Oh, yep, Rebel 1 and trying to make any headway whenever I've seen anyone doing this though, with the new space stations and their fleet complements that they get. This stuff is tough, and your fleet you're starting out with does not have, I mean, you're thinking, oh, well, look, here, I've got between Vader and, Ozel, I've got two ISDs there. I mean, that ought to roll over stuff. And it's like, no, that doesn't work that way anymore. Here, let me get these people on the ground. Don't want to leave them in space. I've already got two there. I'm gonna get another one of these. I hate using these because it's like they're just, I guess they're cheap enough that, you know, it's like anything they use against fighters right here. I know that here I need to go ahead and get rid of that. What do I want? I mean, these cost less, their weekly income, 300. I mean, this is going to be, and I can upgrade it. Well, let's see. I can get up to, no, I can get an army headquarters. So I can't really upgrade this.
Constructing.
Give me some income first, but, you know, they're going to be wanting to raid this place. But I've got places to build units at Corita and Anaxis coming up. Corita, I think I'm going to be leaving. Even though it can go up to an elite barracks, at least at first, I'm going to leave it here.
Upgrade complete.
Ammo at a standard barracks. And
enlisting soldiers.
However, at Anaxis, the plan is
tactical battle imminent.
Jägerminer. Okay. So, being attacked by the Black Sun. It can go either way here, I think. Like I said, you're sandwiched in. So it can be the Black Sun coming from here or the Rebellion coming from here. Okay. I don't know what I'm delaying for. Begin battle. I just want to see what I can do, see if I can knock out some heroes or something. I mean, it's a level one space station, but again, though, with these new space station setups, with their support fleets, I mean, you can actually do... I love the way it was...
Reinforcements en route.
The way it's been described, pretty sure it was...
Reinforcements en route.
Captain Shack said it, I think, that, you know, it's like, instead of this being the way it was before 2.9, where you just have a space station sitting here that just had a few fighters,
Reinforcements en route.
And it's just under attack and you just want to speed it up or auto-resolve or anything like that. It's like, you actually feel like, well, hey, these are all free units, but I can actually do something with this. You know, I can actually inflict some damage. And that does make you feel good.
Ziel auf 2.9. Kurs gesetzt.
Carrot cruiser ready.
Okay, let's see.
Yes, sir. Cruiser ready.
I don't like having
station ready. Orbital command available.
Reporting for duty.
I don't like having the
commander.
The slower ships.
Yes, sir.
In
Quittance cruiser ready.
Grouped in with my
ready, commander.
With like my fighters. Well, I got nothing grouped in with anything.
What'd
I do?
Your command.
Let me try this again.
Ties reporting in.
Awaiting orders.
Okay, I don't know what on earth I did wrong the first time.
At your command. Receiving message.
So, 1, 2, 3.
Decoding transmission.
Okay, let's get...
Yes, Commander.
Hurry up and get through this.
Instead of
taking too much time.
Light cruiser reporting.
Cruiser ready. Carrick ready for orders. Reporting for duty.
Something that does get me about this mod is that... I guess they get targeted a lot too, but man, these Carrick cruisers are just... Oh, they just... They get trashed quick.
Arquitan's ready. At once, Commander.
Full speed.
Heute bereit, sir.
Okay, let's see.
Ready for action. Primary target acquired.
Haben wir Jägerunterstützung?
Com channel open, sir.
Commander.
Get him. See if we can do any damage to Boba Fett without him. I want him away from my fighters. For that reason right there. Well, he actually used his ability, so... Everybody pile on Boba Fett. How far away is it going to run?
Station ready. Locked on.
Sir. Open fire.
Space station under attack.
Activate turbo lasers.
Well, his ability is going to be back up anytime now.
Yes, sir. Ready, Commander. We see them.
an admiral anyway. That's a pretty strong head. Whenever I play as the Black Sun, that is definitely, that is a really good character. Yeah. To have him out is a good thing. Alright, IG-88. I mean, I know you can come back.
At your command. Open fire.
Let's see what we can do about him.
Turbo laser's hot.
I know that I'm using a lot of ships that are not correct for the job, but at this point, I'm just trying to get something done before I die, so. And that's not gonna happen either. I mean, what do I have left? Nothing really.
Oh. Light cruiser reporting.
Where'd he go? I'm missing. But IG-88 is not even showing damage at this time. What the hell? Let's see, maybe somebody can hit Niles Fuhrer. But then again, probably not. No, I mean, shield's totally undamaged, basically.
Reinforcements are no longer available.
I got nothing accomplished there. Wow. Here I end up feeling like I talked it up so much. I got him. Okay, I'll call it a win. That's not a win, but I'll call it one. Just go ahead and get me out of there. Oh, shoot. Now, see, his fleet's here. What?
Constructing unit.
By the way, you start out with two places. You have to have this, the standard Imperial factory, in order to build the probe droids. If you upgrade the factory, you can't build the probe droids anymore, I don't think. And one little thing, another one that you have here to start out with, where you might not notice it, is down here. But you have another capability because you can build something else here. You need to hit this button when you need to unpause it. But you can build them here as well, but they're off the list. You don't see it. So you have to, anyway, just so you know, if you didn't already. Oh, now look, let's look at this info here. Okay, well, we have different ones. Ithor changed the rebellion, Bespin control from neutral to rebellion. Endor control from neutral to Black Sun, could see that coming. Rebel space victory at Jaeger Minor. Ships lost 23. Now, I'm assuming that's 23 points worth. That's 23 cap out of possible 200 in a normal fleet at a single time. If the war changed from Rebellion to the Black Sun. So, okay, Ithor's getting corrupted because it's Black Sun now. But Jaeger Minor, now we have that here, but I was just looking at it for his fleet being gone from here, wondering, as I was building probe droids, is I wanted to see if he had left us enough, if he moved enough away from there, if I could possibly hit it with a full force of my combined fleet. And it's like, now I'm sure, now he's retreated. If he retreated from there, he's going to retreat to here, probably, assuming he has something in orbit there. I'm assuming there's got to be a station there or something, right? But
Moving to that location.
He'll be back at Ord Mantell before I can do anything about it, before I can combine my fleet.
Main cannon's charged.
Give me a medium document.
Upgrade complete.
Is there anything about Manon that's really that important to me? No, and low pop cap. Space drive, I mean, there's nothing about it that's really that impressive or anything. I mean, I can defend here as well as I can defend there. Yeah, it's nice to be pushed out. But... Space defense. Imperium Oval Space Support Station. Receiving our quittance. Okay. Well. I was kind of wanting to build one of those for somewhere anyway, but... What the hell?
Beginning construction.
Build one. What is the income here? Base income 75. Just doesn't really justify this too much. But, I mean, it doesn't justify it to build it, but, I mean, it's already here. But, this is... Well, I don't really have the money for anything else at the moment. I would have to sell that.
Complete.
But notice, now the main things that got my income higher, by the way, it's more getting rid of expenses than it was anything else. I do like the idea of the Black Sun and the Rebellion actually having to fight it out here. There's nothing on that planet, though. They're leaving it in my custody. It's like, all you gotta do is land on it at all, and it's yours.
Construction complete.
So these two, by the way, well, not that one. What was it? But these two planets, I mean, between these two stations that I built, I spent 5,000, but they're making me 1,000 a week already. So that, I guess that is a substantial part of that income. That income increase anyway. I'll tell you what, see, you know, to me, something like this, again, space station, I mean, yeah, this fleet, I want to actually fight this, okay, if nothing else, I'm on YouTube doing this, I'm going to fight this battle, and I'm actually going to fight it just as hard as I can. I'm going to invest actually a bit more into it, even. Let's see. I want to see about the upgrades I can do here with this level one station. I'm unsure about exactly what I can do with that at this time. But this video has already gone a bit longer than I normally do.
Receiving message.
Armor plating, and if that's damn. Oh. Movement speed, energy pool, that's not damage. So. I'm going to be getting minus damage. You got to get to the second. You got to get to the next larger station in order to have the damage so that you can do that. Well, anyway.
Reinforcements en route. Reinforcements en route.
Order, sir. With pleasure, sir.
But yeah, it might be worth, if I can damage these heroes, like, if I can take Shaq out of the game, he can't be rescued. So getting rid of him and the Liberation would be
en route.
A big boost for me.
Orders, sir.
Kreuzer bereit, sir. Kurs gesetzt. Ziel auf 2-9. Kurs gesetzt.
Reporting in. I copy. Confirmed. Right away.
Awaiting orders. Navigating.
Arquiton's ready. Moving to coordinates.
Okay. I guess we've got all our reinforcements in here. So we can go ahead and group these up.
Sir.
I don't know how much it helps to actually to do some of these whenever you have no numbers.
Decoding transmission. Any traction.
Amelie Unterstützung. Kreuzer bereit, sir.
Arquiton's crews are ready.
I want to get my groups in order here. Sorry. Give me a moment. What kind of range do you have on this? Max range is 2,500. Ideal is 2,000. And you are max range 4,000. Okay, yeah. I was going to say. We're going to keep you pulled back into a different spot.
Awesome.
Arquiton's ready. Comm channel open, sir.
Carrot cruiser ready.
Sir.
Cruiser online.
I'm gonna set ready. You up in the 8 position, so let me make sure I got everything in order. 2, 3.
Station ready.
Kreuzer bereit, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, Commander.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
But we have an extra carrot. These things can do a lot of damage, but man, they get focused down. And die rapidly, it seems like. These Carrick cruisers, I've watched other people play, and they had something very similar happen. It's like every battle they were in, it seemed like it's like, well, they've tried to replace my Carricks. Just like.
Arquiton's crews are ready. Make haste. Powering engines.
Let's see, what are we going to target here first? I want to hit stuff that's easy to knock out.
I'll be promoted for this.
Kreuzer bereit, sir. Energie auf Waffen umgeleitet.
Light cruiser reporting.
Target acquired.
Your order, sir. Attacking.
Kill that thing real quick. Okay, now. There she is back here. These things will just die pretty fast, though. Right? So.
Locking on target.
Order, sir.
Intercepting.
Everybody just go ahead and fire at this. I don't know how much we're going to end up being able to do here about any of this at all, but come on. It's like once somebody actually starts firing at it. It's like, well, where did... I can't see... Shit, there was another ship that I wanted to fire at that was in there. Where did it go? There. Is that it? Yes. Alright,
Heizer bereit, sir.
Aquitan's ready.
Cruiser standing by.
Well, I mean, what else do we do here besides...
Receiving message.
I'm being understood, sir.
Com channel open, sir.
Ready, sir.
The hell with it. Charge. I don't know what else to say. I guess... Not being very elegant, I guess. Some of his weapons and so on. Cut down on the incoming fire. I don't know where. Shaq is not showing up here. Does he not show up as a hero on there? Is this him? Yeah, oh, that is him. Oh, shoot. I was expecting. Okay.
Sir. Cruiser ready.
I want you to go after her.
Move to attack.
Did we get his engines? She doesn't have engines, does she? Oh, those are engines left. Everything.
Yes, sir.
Haben wir Jägerunterstützung?
Oh, anyway. Everybody, engines. Okay, I think we got him. Okay, even if I lost ships at all, that would be well worth it. And we took out some other things. Three Nebulan B frigates. We didn't take him out? There was another engine there? Oh, God. How stupid do I look now? I was expecting him to have been dead. Anyway, we inflicted some damage. Okay. Well, I'll tell you what. That's enough for this session. This has been episode 1 of a new playthrough of episode 2.9. We're going to see if we can survive. Not doing so great. Like I said, I thought I took out Shaq. And I did not. But, should have had him, I feel like. But I will see you all for episode 2.